Hey, Roy Marco with Marco Custom Fab. Today I'm introducing my 1967 Chevelle. It's a little bit of a beast. It's a two-door hardtop. I just picked it up a couple weeks ago. It was a pretty fast deal I had to make. I wanted to film picking it up or you know, get some pictures. It was sort of one of those deals where I found it on an ad, and I had got 2 or 3 minutes after the ad was posted. And I'd phone and just, I went down and picked it up. I didn't get time to prepare or set up any filming. I got a couple of pictures of what it looked like when I got it. We pulled this car out of the bush. I actually had to drive it over, like, you know, pull it over a couple of trees, little ones, just to, you know, get it out. It was kind of grown in. It had sat in the bush for 15 years. Gentleman had bought it and just sort of put it there and forgot about it. And he went to go sell it. So it was kept in a tarp. That may have hurt it. I don't know, you know, sometimes it holds moisture. It did keep the sun off the car. This is original paint. This, what you see here, is actually gray primer underneath, not blue paint. So this is the original color, this maroon color. My buddy came over and he said, yeah, the color of this car is original. Same with the fact that it's got a painted roof. That was an original option on the car. It never had vinyl. This is a Malibu, not a 300 or a Chevelle SS, but it's a V8 car, 283, two-speed power glide, and it didn't have these wheels and hubcaps on it when I got it. The wheels I had, they're 1967 Camaro wheels. They have a little deeper offset. They're 14-inch wheel, so the hubcap actually sits within the edge of the wheel, is where the original wheels, these hubcaps would stick out past the rim. I had the hubcaps. I used to have a 66 Chevelle 300 that I used to drive daily, and I bought these at a swap meet, but they're not exactly the same as the 66. The black Chevy bow tie is silver on a 66 with a black circle here, and 67, this is you know, the polished stainless with a black bow tie. So anyway, I bought them at a swap meet and I had them run around, so it worked out perfect for this car. Not much to really show you right now. Needs to be gone through. I want to get it running. It is dry seized, so I'll do some videos on getting it unseized using some diesel fuel down the cylinders. If I can't get it unstuck, I have another engine to throw in it. I want to be able to get this car mobile so I can move it around the yard without having to push it. So as you can see, I'll just show you. Engine stuck. So anyway, we'll get to that. I'll do some videos on this car, how to clean it up. There's a lot of mice have gotten into this car. I got to pull the carpet out, headliner out, and I'll do that, and I'll show you guys how to maybe store a car if you're going to keep it for a little while. You might want to pull the carpet out, not have it in, just to keep things like rust and stuff, moisture, from spreading. So we'll get to it, and if you want to leave in the comments what you think I should do, or if you have any ideas. I was thinking about even just getting this car running, leaving it looking the way it is, and maybe do a road trip, something like that would be kind of fun. Try, you know, get it together on a weekend or something, go to a show in another city, car show. Anyway, if you like, please subscribe and leave a comment below, and I'd be happy to read them. Thanks, have a good day.